reactive power control of grid-tied solar inverters with generators. Why is it required? In this session, we will explore the reactive power control requirement expected from grid-tied solar PV with diesel or gas generators by the PV Genset Controller. Hi, I'm Shaf Ali from ICSS Engineering. We specialize in solar SCADA and control systems required for safe and productive integration of grid-tied renewable solar energy in existing power infrastructures of industries and commercial applications. Grid-tied solar inverter technology is designed to work with the primary source, which is usually a grid. Most of you folks will be surprised that the primary source of grid-tied inverters can also be diesel or gas generators. In case you are new to this, you might be curious about why would someone wish to run grid-tied inverters with generators. Simply because either grid is not available there, or they may have weak grid infrastructure that is failing to ensure ample electricity supply. Solar in conjunction with generators will take up load, running generators on optimal load and saving on fuel. Solar inverters are set to unity power factor by default. With a power factor of 1, the inverter does not generate or consume reactive power. The reactive power in a power system is the result of nature of on-site capacitive or inductive loads. Consequently, everything related to reactive power is reflected on the generator. When solar energy begins generation in a power system, the ratio of active to reactive power can be disturbed, bringing down the power factor on the generator side. Following impacts may occur when the power factor drops on the generator. The voltage at the generator end will rise, increase in excitation current, rise in the stator and rotor temperature. Output of the generator will be reduced, magnetic flux density in the core increases, heat damage to insulation and other circuit components. Larger currents at low power factors mean that the generator will have to work harder to produce less power. Due to the negative impacts listed above, the service life of generator shortens as well as performance is impaired. For example, when the power factor of generator is around 0.7, the output of generator will be reduced by 8%. Interesting fact. Most of the time when you buy an inverter, you will see its power rating in kilowatt, which is active power. On the other hand, when studying diesel or gas generators, evaluation of KVA, which is apparent power, is considered. For diesel or gas generators, a power factor of 0.8 is assumed. In certain scenarios, on request, generators with some other power factor are also assumed, but those are very special cases that they are not commonly used. This only states that the generator can handle reactive power up to 20% of its rated power. You will be amazed that all grid-connected string inverters can perform the same magic. Grid-connected inverters can to some extent be made to dynamically generate or consume reactive power in order to correct the power factor on the generator side. However, depending on the power factor setting of the inverter by controller, it may affect the amount of power generation in kilowatt hour, which is mostly insignificant in this case against the fuel saving one gets from such a microgrid. The power factor on generator end must be strictly monitored once grid-tied solar is installed in the facility. Tuning parameters of PV genset controller or microgrid controller must be reviewed to rectify such issues. PV genset microgrid controllers must always have a power factor correction function built into them, which is handling it dynamically by correcting the power inverter's power factor in leading or lagging condition. We have and will be covering more topics related to PV microgrid design, PV genset controllers, and solar SCADA monitoring. Check out this video's description for the links. You can browse this YouTube channel for PV genset hybrid projects based on energy PK PV diesel controller. You can also visit our website www.icsswu.com for details. For local and international energy PK PV diesel controller inquiries, fill in the Google form link provided in the description or contact us through email, call, WhatsApp, Emo or WeChat. We are glad to offer much required solar operation and maintenance SCADA system called PV SCADA Max. PV SCADA Max is a complete O&M SCADA solution for medium, large or very large scale PV solar integration projects. Salient features of PV SCADA Max are high level of scalability from 100 kilowatt to multiple gigawatts, real-time monitoring of each grid-tied solar inverter and its respective strings,
real-time alerts and alarm logs in case of any alarms on inverters, real-time monitoring of energy mix between various sources, for example, grid, solar, and generators against weather data, transparency of energy generation and consumption reporting, historical trending of parameters, integration of data from third-party SCADA control equipment or process-sensitive instruments, fact-based data for root cause analysis. For local and international energy PK-PV diesel controller inquiries, fill in the Google form link provided in the description or contact us through email, call, WhatsApp, Imo or WeChat. Thank you for your time. Thank you.